Also in Washington, CBS News political analyst John Dickerson. John, good morning.
Good morning, Harry.
Let's talk about these Bush tax cuts a little bit. We'd say it over and over again. We've been saying it for months now. A lot of people really don't understand what's at stake here. President Bush put in these tax cuts a couple of years ago. They're set to expire at the end of the year. What is all this? What's all the haggling about?
That's right. They were designed to expire at this time, but the problem is nobody wants them to expire, but Republicans and Democrats can't agree at the moment on how to basically design them. And if they can't come up with an agreement, then everybody's taxes will increase. So the White House and the president says he doesn't want to give a tax cut to millionaires and billionaires, and Republicans say you've got to give a tax cut to everybody. And so now they're trying to dance around and figure out how they can come up with some kind of agreement, because they know in the end they have to do something.
One of the things that's been floated in the last 48 hours or so was, okay, let's keep this permanent for almost everybody except people making over $1 million, and then maybe add an incentive in here, and we'll have tax breaks for small business people. Might that actually get through somehow?
Senator Mark Warner of Virginia, a Democrat, has suggested that. Republicans don't want to delink these two, because they know if that happens, then maybe the middle class tax cut will pass more politically popular, and then they'll lose that larger tax cut for everyone. This is being floated. It's one of the things that will be in the pot. There's another suggestion from Chuck Schumer, Democrat of New York, to raise that family level up to $1 million. In other words, everybody under $1 million gets a tax cut. I don't think Republicans are going to jump right at those two alternatives at the moment.
Right. Now, the Congress, leaders of Congress and the president are supposed to have dinner pretty soon. And what's the anticipation about that?
They are going to have dinner. There will be some humble pie and some crow eaten, probably. And they will have to get past the fact that they've all been saying these terrible things about each other on the campaign trail for the last several months. But this is the beginning of the ice-breaking process. The president has said, and he said on his way back from his trip last night, that he wants to go back to his first principles. One of them is bipartisanship. Yeah. And so he's got to start trying to find a way to work with these Republicans.
It's so interesting. Even as these young Congress folk come into town, there's a tug of war already within the Republican Party. The Tea Party folks say, we're not so sure we want to go to all these orientations because we don't want to be corrupted by you.
A lot of people have come to town to push against the system they are now a part of, and we'll see it in two interesting ways. There's going to be a vote among Republicans about what to do about earmarks. Earmarks are not a huge part of the budget. They're not a huge creator of this enormous budget deficit.
Yeah.
Very small indeed, but they are symbolically large, and a lot of these Tea Party candidates signed pledges. Some of these members who came back in the Senate want to keep earmarks, and so there will be a fight there. And then there will also be this fight about the tax cuts. What kind of a compromise will Republicans stand for with the president?
All right. John Dickerson in Washington, thank you very much. Do appreciate it. Good to see you.
Thanks, Harry.